What's up, guys? I'm about to take you into a server room. We're gonna do a humidifier bottle today on a Liebert unit. What's very cool about these bottles is they come as an entire kit. Hose clamps, hoses, it's pre-wired with a diagram slapped right on the thing. The job didn't go exactly as planned and I had to maneuver, change things up a little bit and take an old part off the old bottle in order to get the job done, or I would have had a potential leak on my hands. So let's get to it right now. This video is brought to you by Harago.com, trades only platform helping you find the right job or the right candidate. Harago.com, best in trade. Okay, so we're gonna get this humidifier bottle changed out today on this Liebert unit, and I have the new one. I'll show you what it comes with. It comes with a full kit, which is pretty cool, pre-wired and everything. Now, what we have to do first, and I've already done that, is drain the water down from the tank. There's a button. We step back a bit on the right hand side on the electrical. This is an older Liebert unit. There's a button here, we can drain that down. So let me show you what's in the kit. So in this kit, we have the bottle, wiring diagram on it already. It's pre-wired up with some boots over the wiring to protect you from touching it. Okay, one thing that I would be cautious of and I'm gonna tell you guys about is I've had issues in the past where this seam wasn't welded properly and it actually started to leak out. So always inspect the seam going across the entire humidifier bottle. And we also get in the kit, we get some new tubing and we get some instructions and we get all new hose clamps in this kit. So it's a pretty cool kit. You get everything you need within it to change out the old existing bottle. So before we get started and before I change it out, let me just show you quickly how the system works to humidify the space. So on a call for humidification, let's say we're starting from scratch with a brand new bottle, what we're gonna do is this valve here, this is the fill valve, it's got a little solenoid there, it's gonna open up, it's gonna fill this bottle up. Okay, once it gets to a certain point, it's gonna stop the fill. Okay, the contactor for the humidifier is gonna pull in, which is right here. Once that pulls in, we're gonna send power through these wires here into the bottle, and there's heaters in the bottle, heating elements. It's gonna heat that water up, the water's gonna boil. The water or the steam vapor is gonna leave through this tube here into this header that has pre-drilled holes in it, and that's gonna make its way into the airstream and humidify the room. So when you're pulling out the drain tubing, which is down here, right there, be careful, because even though I got most of the water out, there's still a little bit in there and it kind of splashed back and got me. That's where all this came from. While we have the cylinder out, I'll show you a couple of things inside. This is your drain cup. Okay, this is your drain solenoid. Right here we have our overfill interface. Basically, if the cylinder gets to a point where it's too full, this is gonna tell the machine and send it into an alarm. And this is right here, your CT, your current transformer, which measures the current of the heater embedded inside of the cylinder. Okay, so the new bottle is in and we're ready to rock. We have the new hoses, new clamps. And what do I always say? 5 minutes to be a better tech. So we want to go around and check all our electrical connections, all our clamps, make sure everything is nice and tight, which I've already done. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and start this up and give it a test run. So you gotta love this old school controller by Liebert. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna hit the advanced button. We're gonna go down to humidity set point. It's right there in the red chart. We're gonna go down to humidity set point, which is at 40, and we're gonna increase it right up there. That way we're gonna run this humidifier to test it all out. Okay, so we've started to fill here. The solenoid has opened up and we're filling water, and you can kind of see the level right there, and it's gonna rise slowly up. Once it gets to the right level, it's gonna shut the water off. The water's gonna boil and we're gonna see the steam come out over here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the FLIR E8XT to take a snapshot of this to see exactly what's happening. Okay, so we have the FLIR E8XT. This is a pre-boil snapshot.
And if we go onto the tank there, we're at about 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's take a snapshot of that. And we don't really see anything coming out the header just yet. Once it gets up to boiling temp and we start distributing steam, I'll take another snapshot with the EXT. Okay, so now the water is boiling inside, but the surface of the tank is obviously going to be a little bit cooler than the water inside. So we're showing about 183 degrees. And if we pan over to the header where the steam comes out, that is now glowing orange. And we can see a light glow right above it there. It's a little bit cooler than the pipe itself because it's cooling as it leaks. So we're up and running, this is working, everything's good to go. I'm going to show you a couple more things before we end the video. Now while it's up and running here and boiling away, we want to make sure that we have no signs of any leaks whatsoever while it filled up, and I don't see any. Okay, and then the last thing we got to do is drain the whole tank down and make sure we have no leaks on the drain side as well. So I'm going to hit the drain button here, starts to drain. We can actually watch the level start to drop in the tank. Okay, so a bit of a snag in the job here. It wasn't draining very fast. So I pulled this out. I'm gonna clean this trap out. What I did find as well is that this thing's been taped. This was connected up in there where the water's draining out to this piece, and it's broken. So I'm in a bit of a jam there. So what I did is I took the old piece that was on here and I modified it, and I'm going to use it in place of this piece. Luckily I had it, so I'm going to modify this, I'm going to clean this out, and hopefully this drains a little bit faster. So that modification with that old piece seemed to do the trick. I'll have to reach out to Liebert to see if they actually have the piece that broke that fits in here, and I can replace that at a later date, but this should work for now. Okay, we've got that trap all cleaned up. We have that piece put in place, and I'm actually saving these rings for when I get the correct piece to put back. And we have drained down to there. So we're pretty good here. That's the humidifier for the Liebert, the kit. Changing it, draining it, cleaning it, modifying it. That's it, guys. Happy HVACing.